Hi guys, this is Michigan Snow Pony Renee, and I'm getting ready to make some supper, and I got to thinking about I should probably make a video about this because I'm going to be using one of my infamous apple syrup jellies that I made this summer. If you'll look back on an earlier video, you'll see I had trouble getting my apple jelly to set up this year. And a lot of you wrote in on that video and said, oh, you haven't had a jelly failure, you've just made glaze for meats and whatnot. And you're absolutely right, that's exactly what I did. What is that? There's no failures, just happy accidents. So tonight I'm going to be using one of those apple jellies or semi-jellies, and it's very simple. It's not even a recipe, it's just maybe a trick, I don't know. And I'm going to be making meatballs. And all I'm going to do is add one of these to some chili sauce, either homemade. Actually, I'm going to be using two chili sauces to one of these. And make a sauce, put the meatballs in it, and we're good to go. I had a recipe years ago, it was my mother's, and I've got to hunt it down, but it called for chili sauce and currant jelly and a few other ingredients to make a sauce for meatballs. And I got thinking about that recipe from the comments that you guys said about it being a glaze for meat. And I thought, you know, I'm going to try that with this apple jelly that didn't set. And sure enough, it made a wonderful sauce. Really simple, two ingredients. My meatballs, you can use whatever meatballs you normally make, but I'm going to mix half ground pork from our piggies with some local beef, ground beef. So half and half, and of course apple's always good with pork, so and I'll show it to you when I get it all mixed up. Okay, now we're going to mix up our sauce. My meatballs are all out of the oven, so we're just going to pour it in here. There's my homemade chili sauce, and my semi-jelly, and I'm going to do another commercial Heinz, there it goes, chili sauce. That just makes my homemade chili sauce last longer. And all you do is put it in your crock pot, mix it up, add your meatballs, turn it on low for a few hours just to let it the flavors get into the meat, and you're good to go for supper. Easy peasy.